Good day, fellow martial artists of the internet, and welcome back. As requested by the high volume of views I received on my latest video, we are going to be back watching another street fight from the TV show Blood Hounds. But this one's even better because now we have bats. Like the kind you swing at balls, of any variety, really. And if that sounds like fun to you, then please consider subscribing to the channel and sticking around for a while, because honestly, if these keep doing well, we're gonna keep doing them, so you at least know what to expect. Okay, I don't really know the background to this story, but we do have a lot of guys versus two of the main characters, so of course they're gonna win, and the bad guys have weapons, which is almost further indicative of the fact that they're gonna get their asses handed to them. But yeah, let's get started. Oh, the beat drop. It's not really a beat drop, but it's telling us they got started. And hot damn. So he broke his finger right there. Clearly, that finger's done. Straight to the face. Excellent movement. They're doing quite well at displaying the works of the body, but also still, like, you know, him hurting his hand right there. Or what it feels like when they get hit with one of the poles. Little feints there. So I guess getting up close and personal with them isn't working, so they resorted to just chucking the bats at them, or the steel pipes, whatever they have. And now he's got his own pipe. Ooh. A lot of height level changes, you know, is crucial for boxing, going to the body and then to the head, and it's great that they're, like, displaying this. He's in no more boxing with them, he's done with their shit. Honestly, he should be dead. Like, they've been sitting there wailing at him with these bats to the point where they look tired. And he's still fighting. I called these bats earlier. They are definitely just steel poles. My bad. See, he's laying it into one guy too long. Hit him with a couple, then move on. You gotta keep an eye on your surrounding. These have got to be the most durable human beings I have ever seen. Holy crap. Yeah, at some point, it's just too many people. I really like how guy in the white saved guy in the green. Now they flipped the script a little bit. I love the headbutt. If I was the goons, I don't know if I'd be willing to continue the fight at that point. Like, I just watched all of my dudes, including myself, get absolutely wrecked by these two men. And we had the weapons. I would definitely not be considering myself a main part of the story if that's how someone did me. On a more serious note, the guy choreographing these fights is not getting paid enough. I don't care what they're paying him. It's not enough. That was absolutely incredible. Like, I don't like fight scenes because they're always very unrealistic. And sure, they, for the most part, just fought one-on-one when very easily 10 of the guys could jump them at once, and it should have been the end of their day. Should have been the end of their story. They have been sent to the Shadow Realm. They're dead. But aside from that, it was fantastic. The head movement, the keeping the hands up, they go into the body, then the head, and then even the pain, them receiving injuries, what it feels like to hit someone in the face, get hit with a metal pole. Like, it was, for a show, for something that is dramatized, very realistic and just very good. But I can go on for days about how awesome this was. If you guys liked it, please remember to leave a like and a comment down below. And as I said before, please consider to subscribe to the channel. That way I can continue to show you these awesome videos and, of course, my reaction to them if that is also what you like. I mean, you're the one who clicked on the video and stayed this long, so it's gotta mean something. And as always, please remember to eat well, sleep well, train hard, and I'll catch y'all next time. Have a good day.